Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have either purchased or plan to purchase one of our PI sanitary pressure sensors. In this video, we are going to go over the programming of this sensor. So, let's get started. So here you have the Learn More section on our website for our PI series pressure sensors. In this video, I'm going over the programming of these sensors. In this section, we go over some commonly used terms in our menu structure, such as HNO, HNC, FNO, and FNC, which are some different types of switching outputs. We also identify what the different LED indications mean on the display of the unit. And finally, we provide you some examples of the different steps needed to take in order to program the units of measure, as well as how to scale the analog output. So now let me take you to the sensor itself and show you how to manually program it using the display and push buttons. In today's video, I am using a PI2798. This part number has a G1 Aseptoflex Vario process connection, and as seen in the installation guideline video, we have different sanitary adapters available for these parts. This specific part number has a measuring range up to 250 millibar, but as always, we have other part numbers available for different measuring ranges. Out of the box, this unit is factory set to display in millibar, as you can see with the LED indication on the display. And I'm going to take you into the menu and show you how to manually program it for a different unit using the display and push buttons. Before I do this, I need to mention that this unit is currently displaying the W532 error because output 2 is factory set for an analog output, and right now I have the output 2 wire not connected to anything. To get this error away, you would connect output 2 to some type of load, or you would change the output 2 parameter to a switching output instead of an analog output. So to begin, to get into the menu structure, you would press the mode enter button. Here you see SP1, which is your switch point for output 1. If you press mode enter again, you would see RP1 for your reset point for output 1. If you press mode enter again, you'll see output 1, which is where you can change your output 1 mode. If you press mode enter, you'll see output 2, where you can change your output 2 mode. And if you keep pressing mode enter until you see EF for extended functions and press set, it'll take you into the extended functions menu. Here you will see UNI, where you can change your units of display. So if I press set, you'll see it is factory set for millibar. And if I hold down the set button, the display will begin to flash and then scroll through your options. So for today's video, I am going to set it for inches of water column. Once you have it on what you want to set it for, you would press mode enter. So now if I press mode enter again, you'll see some other parameters that you can change in the extended functions menu. If I go down to ASP, this is your analog start point for your analog output. So if you press set, you can change this parameter. It is factory set for 0, meaning your 4 milliamp output would be representing 0 inches of water column. Again, you would change this by holding down the set button, and then when you're at the value you want to set it for, you'd press mode enter. And then if you press mode enter again, you'll see AEP for analog endpoint. To change this parameter, you'd press set. It is currently factory set for the maximum range of 100.4 inches of water column. To change it, you'd hold down the set button. It'll begin to flash and then scroll through your options. So for this video, I will set it for 26 inches of water column. When you're at the value you want to set it for, you'd press mode enter. And AEP is what is representing the 20 milliamps of your analog output. So currently my 4 to 20 milliamp output would be scaled for 0 to 26 inches of water column. So now if I press mode enter until I am out of the display, you will now see that the LED indication is on inches of water column instead of millibar. So finally, you can see the ceramic measuring cell on the bottom of the sensor. And if I apply pressure to this, you will see the pressure on the display increase. So that concludes this Tech Insights video on the programming of our PI series pressure sensors. As always, you can check out our Learn More section on our website to find helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.